Hi friends, today we are going to discuss how to solve word problems based on simultaneous linear equations. So in this video we will be discussing about the word problems that are based on ages and incomes and savings, that is on money. So let us go through the first question that's on your screen. The age of a man is twice the sum of ages of his two children. After 20 years, his age will be equal to the sum of the ages of his children at that time. So, find the present age of the man. So, let us consider man's age, that is this age of man. So, his age is 6 and children 6y. So the question is given, the first case is the age of man. So the age of man is nothing but x is equal to, is means we should take, is equal to twice the sum of the ages of his two children. So the ages of his two children will be y as for our assumption, and twice is nothing but 2, so 2 into y it will become, and which is equal to, so x is equal to 2y, so I can write it as also plus 0, so that I'll get x minus 2y is equal to 0. So this will be our first equation. The second equation is, or the second case in the question is, after 20 years his age will be equal to the sum of the ages of his two children at that time. Find the present age. So after 20 years, so if you consider after 20 years means plus 20, so x plus 20 his age will be, so will be means will be equal to the sum of the ages of his children. So we have the sum of the ages, or we have the children's ages y. So now it is given after 20 years, so in y we are having two children here, so we are having two children, so two children, one children also will cross the 20 years, and another child also will cross the 20 years, so we will be getting 220s, that is 20 plus 20 y plus 20 plus 20. So let us solve it. Plus 20 plus 20 will be cancelled, because when it goes on to LHS it will become minus 20, and x is equal to y plus 20. You are getting x is equal to y plus 20, so x minus y is equal to 20. So x minus y is equal to 20, and the first equation is x minus 2y is equal to 0. X minus 2y is equal to 0, x minus y is equal to 20. I am solving it by using the method of elimination by equating coefficients. So you can see we are having already x and x, so no need to multiply, so we can directly change the sign minus, so x and x will be cancelled, so this one will become plus and this will become minus. So minus 2y plus y, nothing but 1 minus 2y, nothing but minus y. Minus y is equal to minus 20. So y and y will be cancelled. Y is equal to 20. So we got y is equal to 20. That is, the children's age is equal to 20 years. So now let us substitute this value of y in this equation. X minus y is equal to 20. X minus y is nothing but 20. So 20 is equal to 20. So our x is equal to 20 plus 20, that is nothing but 40. I just transpose 20 onto RHS. So we will be getting 20 plus 20, nothing but 40. So this will be, this will be men's age. This will be men's age, and y is equal to 20. This will be the children's age. So we got how to solve the first question. Let us go on to the second question. The second question is on your screen. This is based on expenditures, that is on incomes and expenditures. So it is given, first question is the annual incomes of A and B are in the ratio of 3:4 and their annual expenditures are in the ratio of 5:7. If each saves 5,000 rupees, find their annual incomes. So it is given, savings is given, the expenditures ratio is given, and their income ratio is also given. So they are asking to find the annual incomes. So before, I want to discuss a few important points. That is, for examples, let us take a man. He is working in some office. So his income is 5,000. And he is saving in his bank account 2,000 rupees. And he is spending 3,000 rupees for his family and everything. So this one, what he gets salary is nothing but the income. This is the income. And this one, what he says, 2,000 rupees is called as savings. And the next one is 3,000, that is what he spends. What he spends is known as expenditures. It is called as expenditures. Okay, so you can write expenditures, I am representing it with E. Expenditures is equal to income minus savings. I can also write like that, because see, this is the expenditures, nothing but 3,000. So this is our income, that is 5,000, minus this is his savings, nothing but 2,000. So you can see 5000 minus 2000 is also nothing but 3000. Or you can practically see that the total he gets is X. If the total income he gets as X, something X, and he spends Y, this is his expenditures, and he saves Z in his bank account. So now he will get, so this is the income X is equal to Y plus Z, that is expenditures plus savings. What he saves and what he spends is only from the income. So now we got X plus Y is equal to Z. I can also write Z is equal to X minus Y okay, that is nothing but his savings. So his savings is nothing but income minus expenditures. So definitely Y will be equal to X minus Z. So Y plus Y will be equal to X minus Z. So that is the concept I am using in this question. So let us consider his that here two persons are given, one is A and one is B. So they are asking to find their annual incomes. Let A's annual income be rupees X and B's annual income be rupees Y. Okay, now what they have given in the question is the ratio of their annual incomes. So this is, we considered X as A's annual income and Y as B's annual income. So the ratio is nothing but X is to Y is equal to, the ratio is given 3 is to 4. 3 is to 4. So ratio is nothing but division, that is X by Y is equal to 3 by 4. And on cross multiplying we will get 4X minus 3Y is equal to 0. So 4x minus 3y is equal to 0. Let us make it as first equation. So now on going to the second part of the question, and their annual expenditures are in the ratio of 5 is to 7. So annual expenditures, so expenditures is nothing but savings. Sorry, expenditures is nothing but income minus savings. So their annual income is nothing but what we took is X and Y. So annual income is X and Y. So I am writing here this formula, expenditures is equal to income minus savings. Expenditures I am representing expenditures with E is equal to income with I minus savings with S. So expenditures is equal to income minus savings. So
income minus savings. And what is savings is the question. Here it is given, if each saves 5000, so A is also saving 5000 and B is also saving 5000. So expenditure is equal to income minus savings. X is the income of A and Y is the income of B. So I can write X minus 5000 and Y minus 5000. Because we assumed X as A's income. So first let us take A. A is saving 5000 and the expenditure is nothing but income minus savings. So income is X and savings is 5000. So X minus 5000. I have written here X minus 5000. Same way, Y minus 5000, which is B's expenditure. So, I did division because they asked ratio, and that ratio is equal to 5:7. 5/7. So, let us now cross multiply it. Seven x minus 7 into 5 is nothing but 35000. Seven x minus 35000 is equal to Y into 5, nothing but 5y. Minus, as I'm not having plus, I'm writing down, is equal to 5y minus 5000 into 5, nothing but 25000. So now 7x minus 35000 is equal to, I am writing it side by side, is equal to 5y minus 25000. So if I transpose 35000 onto RHS, it will become 35 minus 25000. So 35000 minus 25000 is nothing but 10000. And if I transpose 5y onto LHS, it will become minus 5y. So our equation will be 7x minus 5y is equal to 10000. So this will be our second equation. So our first equation is 4x minus 3y is equal to 0, and our second equation is 7x minus 5y is equal to 10000. 7x minus 5y is equal to 10000. I am solving it by the method of elimination by equating coefficients. So I'll multiply 4x minus 3y is equal to 0 with 5, and the 7x minus 5 is equal to 10,000 equation with 3. I'm equating y variables coefficients. So this will be multiplied with 5, and this will be multiplied with 3. So 4 into 5 is nothing but 20x. Minus 5 into 3 nothing but 15y is equal to 0. 5 into 0 nothing but 0. And 7 into 3 nothing but 21x minus 5 into 3 nothing but 15y is equal to 10,000 into 3 is nothing but 30,000. So if this will become plus 15y and minus 15y will be cancelled. So all the changes will change, that is, this will become minus and 30,000 will become plus. This one also will become minus because it is in plus sign. So minus 21x plus 20x is nothing but minus x is equal to minus 30,000. So minus and minus gets cancelled. So x annual income is nothing but 30,000. So x annual income will become 30,000. So let us substitute this value of x in any of the equation, that is, we shall substitute that in 4x minus 3y is equal to 0, this equation. So 4 into x is nothing but 30,000 minus y is equal to 0. 4 into 30,000 is nothing but 120,000, 120,000. Which is equal to 3y, so it will become plus 3y when it goes on to RHS. 3y, so 3 ones are 340,000, sir. Is equal to y, so our y is equal to 40,000 and x is equal to 30,000. So now we have solved the second question, so let us go on to third question. The question is on your screen. A and B both have some pencils. If A gives 10 pencils to B, then B will have twice as many as A. And if B gives 10 pencils to A, then they will have the same number of pencils. How many pencils does each have? So let us consider the pencils. with A as X pencils and with B as Y pencils. So A is having X pencils and B is having Y pencils. So according to the first case, A and B both have some pencils. If A gives 10 pencils to B, so A is giving, so X is giving 10 pencils. If it gives 10 pencils, it will have 10 pencils less. So it will be minus 10. Which is equal to X minus 10 is equal to, I wrote minus 10 because A will lose 10 pencils because it gave to Y. Sorry, it gave to B. If it gives 10 pencils to B, then B will have twice as many as A. So B will have twice as many as A. So A will be X plus 10 because it received 10 pencils from A. So this is our equation. Let us solve it. X minus 10 is equal to 2X plus 20. So it will come X sorry this will be Y Y and X minus 2Y is equal to 30. X minus 2Y is equal to 30. So now we got the first equation. So I am just rubbing it. So I am writing it again to let you understand more clearly. So if A gives 10 pencils to B, so A is giving 10 pencils to B, so and B is receiving 10 pencils from A, so Y plus 10. So now B will have twice as many as A, so twice of A, so it will become twice of A. So this will be our equation. So 2x minus 20 is equal to Y plus 10. So 2x minus Y is equal to 30. So let us go to the second case of the question, that is, and if B gives 10 pencils to A, so now comes the part of B, so B is Y, gives 10 pencils to A, so it will become minus 10 because it has lost 10 pencils. B is giving 10 pencils to A, then they will have the same number of pencils, so is equal to X plus 10 because X has received 10 pencils. So you will get X minus Y is equal to minus 20. So 2x minus y is equal to 30. This is our first equation. And the second one is x minus y is equal to minus 20. So if I change this minus sign into plus sign, y and y gets cancelled, and this one will become minus and this one will become plus 2. So 2x minus x is nothing but x, which is equal to 30 plus 20 is nothing but 50. So we got x is equal to 50. So if we'll substitute this x value in this equation, x minus y is equal to 20. So we'll get 50 minus y is equal to 20, and y is equal to 50 plus 20, nothing but 70. So y is having 70 pencils and x is having 50 pencils. So a is having 50 pencils and b is having 70 pencils. So let us go to our fourth question. We have solved with our third question. So now here it is given something about the ages. So 5 years ago, A's age was 4 times the age of B. So 5 years ago, A's age was 4 times the age of B. And 5 years hence, A's age will be twice as the age of B. Find their present ages. So let us take A's ages. X years, and B's ages, Y years. So in the question, 5 years ago means nothing but back or previous, you can say. So 5 years ago, 2021, 5 years ago is nothing but 2016. So 5 years ago, that is, so 5 years ago means they will have 5 years back. They will be in the time of 5 years hence. Sorry, 5 years ago. So it is given A's age will be 4 times the age of B. So B's age also will be 5 years ago, right? So A's age, this A's age only will be equal to 4 times the age of B. This will be 5 and this will be 4 times the age of B. Let us solve it. X minus 5 is equal to 4y minus 20. So x minus y is equal to 4y minus 20. So on transposing 20 onto LHS, on transposing 20 onto LHS, it will become plus 20. So we will get plus 15. So on transposing x onto LHS, we will get 4y minus x. So it will be 4y minus x is equal to 15. This is our first equation. And the second equation is, or the second case is, 5 years hence. Hence means nothing but after. So 5 years hence means both will get plus 5 years. That is x plus y and y plus 5. X plus 5 x plus 5 and y plus y 5 we are having. So we are having 5 years hence A's age will be twice the age of B. So A's age is nothing but x and B's age is nothing but y. So A's age will be twice the age of B. So B is nothing but y plus 5. So twice the age of B. And A's age will be twice the age of B. So this is A's age after 5 years, that is 5 years hence. And B's age is nothing but twice the age of A. That is, this one is A and twice the age of B will be A. So let us solve it. X plus 5 is equal to 2y plus 10. So we'll get 2y minus x is equal to minus 5. So let me write here. Two y minus x is equal to minus 5. So this will become plus. We have to change plus. So x and x gets cancelled. And we'll have this one as minus and this one as plus. Just we have to change the signs. Now we'll get 4 minus 2, nothing but 2y. Is equal to 15 plus 5, nothing but 20. So where 2 1s are, 2 10s are, you will get y is equal to 10. So what is y? That is our assumption of B's age. So B's age will be nothing but 10 years. So we can substitute the value of y in any of the equation. I will take 2y minus x. This equation is there, no? 2y minus x is equal to minus 5. So I will substitute in this equation. 2y minus x is equal to minus 5. 2, y is nothing but 10. So 2 will be multiplied with 10 minus x is equal to minus 5. So 2 into 10 nothing but 20 minus x is equal to minus 5. Minus 5. So minus x will be equal to minus 5 minus 20 nothing but minus 25. X will be cancelled and minus will be cancelled, minus minus. So our x is equal to 25 years. So what is x actually at the starting of our assumption? That is S age. So S age will be nothing but 25 years. This is age and nothing but 25 years. So we got B says and age. B says is nothing but 10 years and age is nothing but 25 years. So that's all for today's videos, friends. Thank you for watching my video. Please do like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel. In the next video, we will be doing miscellaneous problems based on simultaneous linear equations, and after that we will be doing some revision sums. And in that next video, we'll be moving on to another chapter that I will let you know, or you can comment below that which chapter do you want. So thank you for watching my video, friends. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, friends.